students, after the explanation of Boyle's law, today I will explain you Charles law. It is the volume of a given mass of a dry gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature and if the pressure remains constant. Here you can see the experiment which depicts the Charles law. Mathematical term of this Charles law, it is B directly proportional to T. What is the meaning of this mathematical term? Means if temperature is increasing, volume is also increasing. If temperature is decreasing, volume is also decreasing. Here, suppose a gas occupies volume V1 centimeter cube at T1 temperature and volume V2 centimeter cube at T2 temperature, then means gas ki jo initial conditions hai, initial condition bhi kya hai, volume is V1 centimeter cube and temperature is T1. So but this expression will become this, V1 is directly proportional to T1. Here V1 equals to K into T1. What is this K? K is proportionality constant, and here the student K is constant here. Clear? And this expression will become V1 upon T1 equals to K. Here you will put equation number 1. Then final condition, if the volume is V2 centimeter cube and temperature is T2, then what will be the expression in this law, gas law? Here B2 is directly proportional to T2, and this expression will become B2 equals to K T2. Again I am repeating, this is proportionality constant, and here we have taken K here, and the pressure is constant in the Charles law. Here this expression will become V2 upon T2 equals to K. Here we will put 2. Combining both the terms, we will get V1 upon T1 equals to V2 upon T2 equals to K at constant pressure. Again, I have written this expression. Okay, I am putting this expression in the box, and this is called Charles law equation. And students, here in this Charles law, we will use Kelvin scale of temperature. And what is the use of this Kelvin scale? Advantage of this Kelvin scale of temperature is all the values on this Kelvin scale are positive. Okay. So first of all, I will show you both the scales of temperature. Already you are familiar with Kelvin scale of temperature and Celsius scale. See both the scales of temperature, students. This is the Celsius scale of temperature and this is Kelvin. अब यहाँ पे जो Celsius scale है उसका lower fixed point देखो, यहाँ पे 0 है. Okay, Celsius में 0 है lower fixed point, means अगर Celsius में temperature 0 degree Celsius है तो वो Kelvin में कितना होना है? 273. अगर Celsius में temperature, see the upper fixed point of Celsius scale, this is 100. एंड यहाँ पे 373 है केल्विन में, मींस अगर सेल्सियस में टेम्परेचर 100 है तो केल्विन में कितना होना है? 373. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दिस इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सेल्सियस एंड केल्विन टेम्परेचर. सी फॉर दिस आल्सो यू आर हैविंग इक्वेशन, रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सेल्सियस एंड केल्विन टेम्परेचर. व्हाट इज द रिलेशनशिप? इट इज केल्विन इक्वल्स टू सेल्सियस प्लस 273, means if Kelvin, Kelvin you have to convert into Celsius, तो आपको ये वाला formula use करना पड़ेगा. Okay, sorry, if you have to convert Celsius into Kelvin, then you have to use this formula. It will be Kelvin equals to Celsius plus 273, means अगर Celsius यहाँ पे 0 है, तो Kelvin कितना आएगा? 273, 0 प्लस 273. अगर सपोज करो सेल्सियस यहाँ पे आपके पास 10 है, तो 10 प्लस 273 कितने हुए? 283. केल्विन इक्वल्स टू 283. तो अगर ओपोजिट करना है आपको सेल्सियस कैल्विन को सेल्सियस में कन्वर्ट करना, तो उसके लिए माइनस करना पड़ेगा, कैल्विन -273, बट इन द न्यूमेरिकल्स यू विल बी गिवन द वैल्यू इन द सेल्सियस, बट आपको उसको पहले कैल्विन में कन्वर्ट करना पड़ेगा। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू विल लर्न दिस मैथमेटिकल एक्सप्रेशन अलॉन्ग विद द लॉ एंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सेल्सियस एंड कैल्विन टेम्परेचर। ओके, थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स।
Thank you.